boys and girls. This morning we are going to carry on with the story of Jesus. Last week we spoke about Jesus calling out his disciples. What is a disciple? A disciple is a follower, and in this case, a follower of Jesus Christ. Jesus was walking on the shore of Lake Galilee when he would see some fishermen busy with their boats and their nets, and he would say to them, "Come, come follow me." And immediately these fishermen would drop what they were doing and follow Jesus. Now that is an unusual thing, wouldn't you say, boys and girls? A man comes by and you are just doing what you're doing every day, busy with your work, and this man says to you, "Come, come follow me." And you drop everything you're doing and follow him. Yes. That is very unusual. But in these men's hearts, they knew there was something special about this man, and they needed to hear what he had to say. They dropped everything willingly and followed Jesus. Eventually, Jesus had 12 disciples following him, coming from all different places and doing different jobs. They just left what they were doing and followed Jesus wherever he went. Jesus began to teach to the people. When he started to speak, the crowds would gather around him. They were amazed at what he had to say, and they asked him many questions, and he would give them very good answers. The people would ask Jesus questions about heaven, about God, about how to be better people, how to treat their neighbors, and asked him about problems that needed solving. And Jesus would answer all their questions wisely. Jesus would tell parables. He would speak to them in parables. What is a parable? A parable is a story with a lesson. And Jesus did that very often. When they asked him a certain question, then he would tell them a story with a lesson. And they, the people, were amazed at his stories, which in the story was the answer to their questions. At other times, Jesus would go into the temple. That is like a church, and read the holy scriptures, the scrolls, the ancient writings that were written down by prophets of old and kept in safekeeping in the temple. He would read from them, and the priests would all gather around him. Remember when Jesus was perhaps the age of 11 or 12 and the family had gone down to Jerusalem to celebrate the feast of the Passover? On their way back, Mary and Joseph realized Jesus was missing. Oh my goodness, they searched all over the place, asked everybody, "Have you seen Jesus?" They had to eventually go back to Jerusalem. And where did they find Jesus? In the temple, talking with the priests. And yes, Yari was, again, as a grown-up man, reading the Holy Scriptures, the writings of the old prophets that had written down prophecies, things that were going to happen in the future, all about God and about the Messiah, which is Jesus, and how he would come to earth, and how he would die, and how he would rise again. Yes, he was reading the scriptures, and the priests gathered around him, and they were once again amazed at his wisdom and how he explained the scriptures to them. Another important part of Jesus's ministry, that is, the work he had to do, was, besides preaching and teaching, was doing miracles and performing healings. Yes, what is a miracle? Well, it is like, say somebody is dead, they're not breathing, they're dead, and Jesus comes along and says, "Hey, wake up, get up." And guess what? That person wakes up, so to speak, and is alive again. Now, can that happen? Is that real? Can that really happen? No, it doesn't normally happen. It's something out of the ordinary. It is what you call a miracle. That is a miracle. Something that could not normally happen. Only something that God can change. And here it was. People had come to Jesus and said, "Please, come and pray for my loved one. They have died." And Jesus would go there and say, "Wake up." And they would be alive again. Isn't that wonderful? That is what you call a miracle. Yes, only God can perform a miracle, can do a miracle, can make a miracle happen. Yes. A man came to Jesus that was deaf. He couldn't hear. And Jesus prayed for him. And guess what? His ears opened and he could hear again. Imagine that. You can't hear the birds. You can't hear your mom's voice. You can't hear all the beautiful sounds around you. And you come to the Lord and he heals you. Oh my goodness! And your ears are open and you hear the birds sing. You hear the people's voices. Oh, I can just imagine the joy on this man's face when he started to hear the beautiful sounds that we take for granted, that we hear normally. This man could hear it only now for the first time. What is that? That is a miracle. Soon the news spread all over the country and people flocked towards Jesus. They had heard that Jesus does miracles. He does what no man can do. Only God can do what he does. And many people came to him. People that were blind, people that could not walk, people that had serious diseases. They came to Jesus for healing. Oh, how wonderful! People flocked towards Jesus. And Jesus loved every one of them. He did many, many miracles. And he taught the people the good things. He taught them how to love each other, how to live in peace with each other, how to treat each other. He taught them how to forgive. And many, many questions they had, he answered them, often with parables, that is, stories with a lesson. And yes, Jesus loved them. He loved everybody. God loves everybody. And he loves you, boys and girls. Jesus loves you. Yes, boys and girls, Jesus loves you. So much so that he died for you. He died for you on the cross, for all the things we have done wrong, for all the things that have gone wrong in the world, right from the Garden of Eden. There in the Garden of Eden, where the serpent deceived Adam and Eve and made them be disobedient to God and what he told them to do. God, Jesus, died for us for one reason, that he loved us and he wanted to make us pure again. What a wonderful thing. But remember, after Jesus had died, for 3 days he was in the grave, and then he rose again, and he lives forevermore. That is such a wonderful thing. So boys and girls, next year when we are together again, we will learn all about the different miracles and parables that Jesus performed and told the people. We will learn more about what he taught the people. And we will learn all about how he died for us and how he rose again. Thank you, boys and girls, that you have been so positive through this year and you have listened to all these lessons while we were under this COVID pandemic and couldn't have Sunday school at the church. Auntie Kathy loves you all, misses you all, and we're looking so forward to being together again where we can sing and make a joyful noise to the Lord and talk face to face with each other. That is what we are praying for. So you boys and girls must have a wonderful holiday. Enjoy it to the fullest. And remember, be kind and love one another and listen to Mommy and Daddy. Love you all. Bless you all. See you again next year in 2021. Hi there, boys and girls, and hello, one-eyed monster, Milo the one-eyed monster. Good to have you here tonight with us. Okay, it's birthday time. Hey, Freddy, it's birthday time. And yeah, we have Jumbo, and yeah, we have Simba. Oh my goodness, and who are we missing? Oogles! Yes, we've all come to sing happy birthday. And there are two people, two children that have their birthdays in this period. The first one is David. Happy birthday, David. Woo! They're all trying to jump together and wish you happy birthday, David. May God bless you richly. And later on in the month of December, we have Nancy's birthday. Happy birthday, Nancy. God bless you, Nancy. Yes, eh? Milo, come up here. Yes. Happy birthday. Now, Nancy and David, keep watching. There's a little clip I want you to see. God bless you. Lots of love.
And to all you boys and girls, be kind, be happy, and don't forget to say your prayers. And we'll see you again next year. God bless.
Hey, let's sing.
Birthday greetings today. May God bless you, we pray. Live for Jesus, dear David and Nancy. May he guide you all way.
God bless you. Look at the camera. Look at the camera.
Aha, God bless you.
Look what they've got.
A birthday cake.
Beautiful.
And we're going to eat it, hey? We're going to celebrate for you boys and girls. Hey, what's happening? And now we have got a smartie for you guys, hey? Enjoy it, hey? God bless you. Have a wonderful year, hey? What do you think? Happy birthday!
Morning, boys and girls. So this is our last lesson for this year. And I'm sure that you've all learned a lot from the wonderful stories that Auntie Kathy's been telling you about Jesus. And I think we should all say thank you, Auntie Kathy, for spending so much time on teaching us these wonderful stories. Let's give her all a clap. Thank you, Auntie Kathy. God bless you. We love you. And boys and girls, you must all keep safe during the holidays and listen to your mommies and daddies. And those of you, when you come back next year, that are going to Auntie Janice's class, all the very, very best. We're going to miss you a lot. Anyway, boys and girls, we'll see you next year. Be good. Don't forget to pray. God bless you all. Bye. See you. Bye. Love you lots.
Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world. Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious. Jesus loves the little children of the world. Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world. Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in His sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world. Thank you.